wasted until he found his thing. This is all Martin's fault. We hadn't helped Corvo get out of prison. Corvo hadn't been so damn good at his job. We hadn't gotten greedy and afraid. Did you think I'd fight you, Corvo? Sorry to disappoint. Always too sure that I would have done. Never hesitated. Too sure of what I wanted. Too sure of what I wanted to do when other men stopped to consider. Saw it as weak. Did you think I'd fight you, Corvo? Sorry to disappoint. This is yours. The key to Emily's cell. She'll be glad to see you. You made quite an impression on her. Did you know that? She asked about you constantly. Where you were, what you've been doing. I told her. In the end, I told her everything. From the start, when we had such noble goals in mind, to the end, when we were afraid, fighting in secrecy about who we could trust and who we had to kill, arguing over who would act as new Lord Regent. And she listened, eyes wide. She's become an interesting girl. If she lives, she'll make a memorable empress. Go ahead. Kill me or take me to Coldridge Prison. Make your choice. She'll be watching.
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is, with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. And decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.
Long enough for all of the big and the small, where the taller they stand, where the harder they fall. We live for today, but we die for the next. With blood in our veins, in the air, in our chest, or we step into war with our hearts on the line. The dirt on our boots, it shakes free over time. Is a distant aroma at best, a withering smile that's stuck deep in your vest. The night air, it wraps its fingers around your body, it shakes from a now distant sound. Oh, the sound of her voice, a sweet symphony played over and over until you are free.